again for coming. As always, one really prefers for the work to do the talking itself, but sometimes you have to talk about your work. So here we go. A while back, I read that in the last interview that Leonard Cohen did before he died, a couple of weeks before he died, he was asked an interesting question about his creative process. And the answer he gave actually ties in very much with the way I work. And he said, I really don't know what I'm doing. And that made me think that the more deeply you're involved with what you're doing, the more you get up yourself out of the way and let it come out through you, let it happen. And my work is very much process-based. I have to really see things happen in front of me, you know, with my hands. If I get a preconceived notion of where a painting wants to go, I consciously push it in a different direction. Because it has to be a visual phenomena that comes to life right there. And they take a lot of time because they're built from many, many layers, built on top of one another over time, rubbed away, kind of scoured into, and built up again until the kind of synergy is reached, where the whole becomes greater than the sum of its parts. For me, I translate that into, it gives me a tingle, you know, goosebumps, rather. And that has to do with the technical aspect of it. What the work is about for me has a lot to do with the idea of spirituality, which to me actually boils down to what I consider the poetic reading of existence, of being. There's a search for light. That light is like the original light at the beginning, the light that comes through the painting, the light that's manufactured. Somehow it has to do a lot with that, and with music, which is, as an abstract form, it's really closer to the source than anything else. I just want to throw some of these ideas out and let you guide the talk. So if you have any questions, or if you want to push it in a different direction, if you want me to expand on anything, please do. Ready?
This one just blows me away. It's just so beautiful. There's just so many things that you can see in it. Other, like the 17th century, and then there's like, and then all of a sudden that sort of disappears, and it's clouds, and the, you know, I mean, it just goes in and out for me. I want to just keep looking at it.
That going in and out is actually part of the technical thing. So for me also, when a piece takes off, is when the distinction between the foreground and the background is blurred. Mm-hmm. And that gives it a resonance, and that's usually, that doesn't mean by any means that the piece is finished, but that's a good diving board for me, that this resonance begins to happen. Now, how can I tame that, how can I guide it, or take it in a certain direction? That remains to be seen. And I work on many pieces at the same time for various reasons. It came out of necessity, but it actually turned into, it developed its own philosophy. Because when you're working on many pieces at the same time, you don't get tied up with a piece, you get tied up with a creative process, you know, because whatever you really focus on too much, it starts hardening sometimes, it starts losing that soul. So I work on something and it gets stuck, and from the corner of my eye, I see this other one, it just opens up, I go work on this one, and then this one, and this one sits for 2 months, this one for 6 months, the other one is finished in 2 days. As they bounce around, they actually learn from each other and they teach each other. Mm-hmm. And I've learned to kind of step back and let it happen, and learn from that, and to bring that into pieces that come later. No. Any other questions?
Are they all oils?
Yes, they are. I love working with oils, just the smell of it, the way it works, the way it comes. I dabble in acrylic sometimes, but that's really just,
yeah,
it's dabbling. I love oils.
Do you listen to a certain type of music when you're creating?
No, actually, I listen to anything and everything when I'm creating. But the thing is, music has always been such a great part of my life that it's kind of internalized, mm-hmm. You know. There's one piece here that's different than the rest of them, which belongs to a different series. That one, which is from the series Cantata, which is a tribute to Bach. And they all have that kind of texture, those pieces. And somebody asked me that in an interview, do I listen to Bach when I work on those? I said, I don't need to. It's there, it's been internalized.
So I don't look for, when I talk about music, I don't look for translating music into imagery. I look for the music of the piece itself, the music that's in it, you know. Some people do that other thing, sometimes successfully, sometimes not. That's a whole different thing. But music for me is, anything is really music. Poetry is music, the music inside poetry. So I look for the music inside the painting, its own music, not the music that's imposed on it or superimposed on it.
All of the paintings in this room are of a similar coloration. Were you just like working for a couple of years with this as opposed to that's more green, you know?
Right. Because the business process that I just described, the way I work, change really, you know, manifests itself slowly over time in my work, you know, and I'm not really looking for drastic changes. But when you look at the work from now, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, you see some difference and some, I hope, evolution. With color, I challenge myself too. Also, you know, sometimes I throw in a color that I normally don't use or may not necessarily even like, but then I have to work with it and tame it. But after a while, I look back and I see that certain colors become dominant. Somehow those always come to the top. They have the upper hand. So no, it's not a preconceived palette, but it's a palette that's looking back. There is a cohesive palette there. I think I have about 10 minutes, so yeah, thank you very much.
That was
thank you.